Can we make a small drone into a bigger drone? Let's find out. So, making a big drone can be easy if you have all the parts. But you know what? Parts of a small drone and body of a bigger drone combines into a bigger drone. Is it really possible? So to test this thing, I have ordered CSN CX-10, which is a really great drone, by the way, and a body of Cyma XYSW, which is kind of a good, but it has a coreless motors in it, and it is a bigger form factor drone. So there are good chances that we can modify the small drone into a bigger drone. So first I started taking apart the small drone, and it is a really good drone, by the way. The build quality was really good. There is a microcontroller, the motion sensing unit, MPU6050, really popular one, and a RF chip for a transmitter. Small battery was just 100 milliamps per hour to give 4 minutes of flight. The small motors are really powerful for this kind of size. So well, I thought, since we are upgrading the motors of a bigger body, we might need a bigger MOSFET to control these motors. So first I thought I should use IRF Z44N, which is overkill MOSFET. But you know what, after searching into the datasheet of the MOSFET the drone originally has, I found that the CX-10 has a MOSFET which can handle 6 amps, and the motors of the Cyma XYSW only consumes 4 amps at full power. So there is not need to change MOSFETs in there. So firstly I removed all of the parts from the CX-10, then connected 4 bigger motors to the CX-10 circuit board. No, there is no sign of heating of MOSFET. Then I just assembled a bigger drone in a proper way, and there we have it. Our drone is ready. So without wasting any time, let's just fly it. Okay friends, so it's pretty sunny day right here, and I'm going to fly this modded drone. So let's just do that. Wish me a luck. Whoa, crash. Boom! Crash! You know what, the first test flight was kind of a success, but you know what, this drone was just wobbling and it is not stable. In the second flight, I have tried to solve the issue, but here we go. So the drone was making quite a lot of noise, so the propellers are not connected there properly. Okay friends, so this is test flight 2. I have fixed the distance between propellers, so let's fly again. In the next flight, I have upgraded a small part into the propeller section, which really reduced the sound which the drone was creating. So the drone propellers are shaking very violently, and this is the design flaw in this Cyma XYSW. So what I did is took this small straw and sticked it into this part. So now if I place my rotor, the rotor will not move in horizontal direction, it just spins. It is sounding like a drone now. I have tried many things to try to improve the performance of this drone, but what I got up to is this flight. So in this case, our smaller drone has a sensor which are calibrated for the size of the drone. But if we try to install this circuit board into a bigger drone, so these values may just not work out of the box. So we may have to tweak these values, but this is really not possible to upgrade into the firmware of this drone. If you know anything about it, please let me know in the comments down below. So anyways, hope you enjoyed this video, guys. If you learned something from it, please hit that like button, share this video with your friends. Peace.